Here's another exciting religious studies lesson. Last week, we focused on the Last Supper. This week, we focus on part two of the Easter story, from the garden to the cross.
Take a look at these three pictures. What do these pictures have in common with one another? The first picture shows a man holding his back. The second picture shows a girl crying, holding her knee. And the third shows a woman bent over holding her stomach. Did you say it looks like they are in pain? Then you are correct. The three pictures show people that are suffering. Here are today's objectives. After this lesson, students will be able to 1. Examine the path of suffering Jesus took from Gethsemane to the cross. 2. Explain why Jesus was willing to suffer for mankind through Scripture. 3. Justify suffering for one's faith by looking at Jesus' life and Stephen the martyr. Let's begin our journey by looking at the path of Jesus' suffering. Take a look at the picture. Who is in the picture? Where is the person in the picture? If you said this is a picture of Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, you are correct. Jesus and three of his disciples went to the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus went to pray. He was asking God to take away the cup of suffering that would come to him in a few short hours. Jesus realized that it had to be God's will that took place rather than his own will. An angel visited him in the garden and gave him strength for the suffering that was to come. Take a look at this second picture. Who are the characters in this picture? Where are they? What is happening? Jesus is in the garden, surrounded by officers, his disciples, and Judas. At the Last Supper, Jesus had said that one of his disciples would betray him. Judas is the disciple that betrayed Jesus. It was the symbol of the kiss on the cheek that would identify who Jesus was. The officers were getting ready to arrest him. This is the second time that Jesus would endure suffering. It would be one of his own disciples that would cause the suffering. Take a look at this third picture. Who is in the picture? What are they doing? Here, you see Jesus stripped of his clothing, wearing a red robe, a crown of thorns on his head, and carrying a heavy cross, surrounded by officers. Jesus endured suffering from those officers who spat on him, whipped him, and mocked him. In all of this, they made him carry his own cross that he would later be crucified on. Take a look at the scriptures. What do these scriptures mean? Jesus knew that his journey to the cross would involve great suffering. However, he was willing to die for the sins of mankind because he loved us. He also knew that he had to be obedient to his Father. Jesus realized that his suffering would lead to great victory for all believers. Consider these men. How are they similar? The picture on the left shows a picture of Jesus. The picture on the right shows of a picture of Saint Stephen the Martyr. Stephen was chosen by the apostles as the first of seven deacons. He was a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, who performed miracles among the people and brought many to join the followers of Jesus. Stephen, however, was stoned to death because of what he believed in and how he spoke about Jesus. What is it that these two men have in common? Both of the men suffered because of their faith. Let's review what we have learned today. Jesus first endured suffering in the Garden of Gethsemane. He prayed to God to remove the suffering of what was to come from his life. While in the garden, Judas, one of his disciples, betrayed him with a kiss. Jesus suffered as a result of his friend's action. He was arrested. While Jesus journeyed to the cross, he suffered. He was teased and whipped by soldiers, all while carrying the heavy cross. Stephen, just like Jesus, endured suffering. He was stoned to death because of things he said about Jesus. He ended up being named Stephen the Martyr because he died because of what he believed in, his faith.